Hey guys, do you want to know one of the secrets of my soloing and playing riffs in a song? Well, if you do, stick around. That's what we're going to tackle today. Okay, let's dive right in. Last week we talked about chord clusters. And by the way, if you didn't see last week's video, I would recommend you go back and look at it and you'll have a little more, a better understanding of what we're talking about today. So let's dive right in. Let's look at a solo that I did on the new Gaither Vocal Band. Gordon Mote produced that, and there was a really great song called You Amaze Me. Okay guys, let's break it down and look at what I was thinking, which might be a scary thing. But let's look at what I was thinking when I played each part of the solo. So the solo is in the key of F. And actually I have a chart that you can download. If you don't know anything about the Nashville number system, you might want to go back and look at last week's video also. There'll be a link where you can do that, but I just give the basics on the Nashville number system. Okay, this song is in the key of F. You know, Gordon Mote produced this project. When we started listening to this song, we knew it was just a great song. Gordon gave me some direction. He said, you know, sort of a Steve Lukather melodic kind of thing. So Steve is one of my all-time favorites. With that approach in mind, I just wanted to start in a low register. And what I was seeing is, okay, like the first two chords of the solo is F. So I just wanted to start with something. I've always loved the approach of playing sort of the same notes, but fit across different chords of the song. Like in this case, it would be two bars of one. In my mind, I'm seeing an F chord right here, and it's the F position also. And actually in this solo, I mean, that first part starts all on the D string. My mind is actually switching to different blocks, to different positions as I'm playing it. So I start out by seeing this F chord right here. In the middle of that line, I'm seeing the C position, but it's an F chord. And then by the time I end with the last note, I see this A position, which is an F chord. So that's what I'm seeing in my mind as I'm playing the first two bars of the solo. And I just wanted to start with something low and be able to build as the solo goes through. So the first part of it, there was this little eighth note rest, and I played. So right here, I'm thinking of this position here. Okay, now when I slide up to that, my mind's already shifted. I'm thinking of the F chord there. So when I slide down here, I'm thinking there's the F chord. And then it goes to a four chord. And I just wanted to be able to play the same notes. And basically what that makes that is like a major seventh. So then I go on up to the four, back down to the three, and then I slide up to the six. So it's basically the same notes, except the last note when I'm in the one is a five, the last note when I'm in the four is a six. So okay, so that takes care of the first four bars. Okay guys, let's look at bars 5 through 8. Bars 5 through 8 is a really cool progression, I thought. Starting on a 7 flat, like there's your F, go down to the E flat for two bars, to six minor, which I thought was a really cool chord to go to. So what I wanted to do is I wanted to build, but I still wanted to keep it simple and leave room for a more complex line coming up at the end of the solo. Okay, so we're in F. Okay, and I was wanting to go up, so I'm looking at F here. So there's a 7 flat. And there's a 7 flat also, which is E. So what I did is I wanted to get up to this note here, which is the B flat note. Here's what I'm thinking. There's the E flat, which is the 7 flat. There's the 1. There's the E flat. So and then I went down to the 6 minor, which I at that point I'm thinking, okay, there is my F to make a 6 minor. Just add that note there. And you can basically play what you would play in a major scale out of F. So I play the same phrasing, but just different notes. So I'm thinking right there, it's that 6 minor. So, okay, so then I wanted to even build it more from there, and I thought, well, this is a point in the solo. I really probably could play something pretty complex. So, which not real complex, not like Steve Vai complex, but like me complex. So we're still in the 6 minor, and I'm doing pickups out of the 6 minor. So there's the F, there's a 6 minor, but I'm going to start on a 5 note, and I'm going to head up because we're heading to a 2 minor, and I'm thinking there's the 2 minor, and there's the 2 minor down there. So I'm thinking, and I'm hitting this 4 note, and I'm hoping that that line will sort of play across the 2 minor and the 1 over 3. So, so from the 2 minor, so it's, it sort of makes the 1 like a sus. Play a 6, which is playing on a 4 note. So, so that's 2 minor, 1 over 3, and then when you get to the 4, I'm thinking there's the 4 right there. There's the B flat. There's the 1. There's the 4. So I can play that note. That's part of the scale in that. And then the very last lick, I just do an arpeggio, basically, and do a 5 chord, and I wind up landing on a 1 note, which is part of a 4 over 5. So I'm just thinking, okay, there's the 5. The song's in F, there's my 1, there's my 4, there's my 5. So it's going to a 5 to a 4 over 5. So a 1 note will work over the 4 over 5. So I just do an arpeggio. And that's the end of the solo. So, okay guys, that's pretty much it. You got the chart. You can go back over all this if you want to. If you like this video, please share it. If this is your first time watching one of our videos, become a subscriber if you like it. And be sure to share it, comment, and just tell everybody you know about it. All right, until next Saturday, we'll see you. Do you live in constant joy? Can you live in constant joy? Well, what does the Bible say about it? That's what we're going to be talking about today on KB's Plug-In. So let's get started. Let's start by defining the word joy. We want to define the word joy in context with the way that Paul the Apostle uses it in his letters, specifically in the book of Philippians. So we are not just talking about joy in the general sense, but as a Christian understands joy, as Paul uses it. You know, I love John Piper's definition of joy. Christian joy is a good feeling in the soul, produced by the Holy Spirit, as He causes us to see the beauty of Christ in the Word and in the world. So we see here that joy is an emotion. It's not just something that we can just make on our own. Joy is a different kind of emotion than like happiness. Happiness is based upon what? It's based upon our circumstances. But joy is based on Christ. One of the most happiest days of my life was June 8th, 2014. I was so happy to be marrying the most wonderful, beautiful woman in the world. Her name was Sarah Delane, and still is Sarah Delane. Sarah Delane Batt. But my happiness was based on circumstances. I know as a musician, happiness can be based upon, is my phone ringing? How much work do I have on the books? You know, Nashville is a totally different town than it was just a short 10 years ago. Record companies have been forced to cut budgets, and full-time writers, we had 3,000 writers 10 years ago. I'm hearing that we're down to about 300 writers now. So there is just not the work that there used to be here in Nashville. So I know a lot of great singers, a lot of great songwriters and musicians that are not very happy because of these circumstances. But there are many of us who still have the joy of the Lord. It's not based on our circumstances, even though the circumstances might not be all that great. Joy is produced by the Holy Spirit. It is the fruit of the Spirit. Let's go to a couple scriptures. Acts 13, 49-52 says, "The word of the Lord spread through the whole region, but the Jewish leaders incited the God-fearing women on high standing and the leading men of the city. They stirred up persecution against Paul and Barnabas, and they expelled them from their region. So they shook the dust off their feet as a warning to them and went to Iconium. And the disciples were filled with joy and the Holy Spirit." It wasn't about their circumstances that gave them joy, right? 1 Thessalonians 1:6 says, "You became imitators of us and of the Lord, for you welcomed the message in the midst of severe suffering with the joy given by the Holy Spirit." Some of the stuff we go through, we cannot have joy on our own. We have to have the Holy Spirit to help us. So joy is not something that we can just manufacture on our own or make happen in our own life, but a result or a fruit of the Holy Spirit working in our lives. So does this mean that we have no control over having joy? No. In fact, Scripture tells us, "Rejoice always." That's 1 Thessalonians 5:16. You know, Scripture does give us some things that we can do to help us put our hearts and our minds in a place where we can be more receptive to the joy of the Holy Spirit. The Scripture itself brings us joy. John 1:4 says, "We write this to make our joy complete." So part of the reason for the Word is to bring us joy. Hearing the truths and the promises of the Word of God brings us joy. Then there is righteousness. Ecclesiastes 2:26. "For to the person who pleases Him, God gives wisdom, knowledge, and joy." Now this is not an excuse for self-righteousness or faith based on works so that we can receive the good things of God. We live in righteousness because we love Him and we want to obey Him. Ecclesiastes is saying living a life that pleases God means that we are walking in the Spirit, therefore opening ourselves up to joy. James 1 verses 2 and 3. "Consider it pure joy, my brothers and sisters, whenever you face trials of many kinds, because you know that the testing of your faith produces perseverance. Here is where we find out that the joy has little to do with our current circumstances. So let's review. Joy is an emotion that we cannot turn on and turn off, but we can take these steps to open ourselves to the joy of the Lord. Number one, meditation in the Scripture. Number two, living righteously. Number three, when we use our setbacks as a place to build our godly character. Okay, here's the KB challenge. Okay, here's my KB challenge for this week. Will you make a commitment to open up yourself to the Holy Spirit and to take an active role in finding your joy? Thank you so much for watching this video. If you're new to watching, be sure to subscribe to my channel. Doesn't cost you a penny. Please share this video and leave a comment. All right, see you guys next Saturday. Okay, guys, it's time for the KB giveaway winner. Let's just go right ahead and draw a name. Good luck. By the way, thank you all for subscribing and commenting and sharing. Okay, here we go. And the winner is... I'm gonna need my glasses. Stefano Madalino. Congratulations, you're the winner. Okay, guys, be sure to continue watching and hit the bell so it'll notify you, because we're going to be giving away a lot more stuff. All right, see you guys next week.